Hey guys, technically Jeff here, and I'm excited to bring you an awesome review today of this CarPlay dash cam from One Car Stereo. This gives you the same functionality as the AI box that I reviewed from them previously, so you can watch videos on your car's display, you get wireless Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, but this comes with a built-in dash cam.
Dash cams can definitely come in handy and help if you're in an accident. This one features automatic loop recording and accident detection, which is great. I think it's awesome they were able to integrate the dashcam functionality along with the CarPlay Android-based AI box, which provides wireless Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, the ability to watch videos in your car's display, and use a variety of different apps. It's plug and play, and everything shown here is included, including obviously the device itself, a micro SD card, the necessary cables, and a wire trim tool to help run the wires. I'm going to go over all the details with you guys, so let's get to it. Starting with the box here, you can see it outlines the main features of the device. A couple things to highlight, it does have a nice 148-degree wide-angle view, which is wider than a lot of other dash cams I've seen, so you can actually fit more in the video, which is good. It records in 1080p video, which is pretty standard for dash cams. This allows you to have good quality video that doesn't take up tons of storage. Turning it over on the back here, it has more details. It has 4 gigs of RAM and 64 gigs of internal storage. It has an octa-core processor, built-in GPS, Bluetooth, dual-band Wi-Fi, and it supports a SIM card for data if you don't want to use your cell phones or car's built-in Wi-Fi hotspot. But yeah, let's go ahead and take it out. So we've got the manual here. Then the device itself. It's nice and fairly compact. It also feels pretty solid quality-wise. You can see the ports here for the USB-C connection, SIM card slot, and micro SD slot with the card already inserted. You can see the angle of the camera module is adjustable too, which is nice. Then we've got this box here. This has the trim tool. A nice long cable to connect the device to the USB data port. It also has an adapter to convert it from USB-A to USB-C if that's what your car uses. And yeah, that's everything. I'll give you a quick view of the manual now. It outlines all the information about the device, how to install it and connect everything, how to set up the wireless CarPlay and wireless Android Auto, how to download apps, warranty information. Now to mount it, in a car like my Kia EV6, I think right here is the best place to mount it. It's up high, so you get a good view of the road in front of you, and it's out of the view of the driver. I'm not going to mount it myself because I'm actually going to give this unit away in the future when we hit a subscriber milestone. But yeah, it looks good. Let's go ahead and get it plugged in and set up. Plugging it in here, it's a nice tight connection. When you load it up the first time, it calibrates the screen to match your vehicle's display resolution, and then it restarts. There's this warning that comes up, reminding you not to use it when the vehicle is in motion. Definitely don't watch videos while you're driving. And it loads up to this home screen with several preloaded apps here. It does run the Android operating system and uses the Apple CarPlay protocol to communicate with the vehicle's display. This circle here is a button that activates a dock where you have quick access to various things like the home button, back button, multitasking, things like that. If you swipe down from the top, you get the normal Android settings menu. On the left here, there's this flashing recording icon that indicates the dash cam is recording, so let's open that up. This opens the dash cam software. You can see it gives a live feed from the dash cam, which is pretty cool. Definitely a nice wide field of view. Opening the dash cam settings, you can adjust the resolution, timestamp, recording time, frame rate. If you want the microphone recorded, sensitivity of the accident detection, storage information. If you go into the loop video section, this is where the various loop recordings are saved. And yeah, it works pretty well. We'll go ahead and hit the home button and return to the home screen. I'll go ahead and sign into Google Play and show you how that part works. Opening up the Play Store here, you can see I have access to many apps, games, video apps, all kinds of stuff. Real quick too, going back to the home screen, this AutoKit button here is how you connect to the wireless Android Auto and CarPlay. That works pretty well too. Now I'll open up a couple of apps here. Opening YouTube, this is what it looks like. You navigate it just like you do the mobile app. Clicking on a video, it works just like it does elsewhere. I felt like I was searching my audio and video quality is good.
Giving away this right here, a Tesla Tap Mini 60 charging adapter that lets you charge your non-Tesla EVs at Tesla charging stations.
So you remember a few days ago, I posted the review of the Tesla Tap Mini 60. It works awesome with the EV6, but no special procedure or anything like that. It's very high quality.
You just tap the display to navigate.
Today, I'm testing out this very useful little adapter called a Tesla Tap Mini 60 that lets you plug in your non-Tesla EV at Tesla chargers, which is very handy to keep in your car. I'm going to test it with this Tesla mobile charger that I'm borrowing from Zach.
Just like a cell phone, too, you get picture in picture, which is convenient.
Go check out his own.
You can go to multitasking here to clear out apps from the memory. Opening up Netflix. I'm not logged in, but this is what you get. You do have the ability to download to watch offline, which is nice. You can see too that the dash cam is still recording through all of this, so you don't have to worry about choosing one thing or the other. So overall, I'm very pleased with it. It looks good and it works well. There's a lot of cable here to route it around the windshield and dash to keep it out of sight. The display and apps are very responsive. You have apps like Waze here too, which works well with a built-in GPS and is full screen, which is nice. In my review of the AI box from One Car Stereo, I use more apps, have windows side by side, things like that. So check out that video for more examples of how to use it. I'll link that in the description. But yeah, it works well, and I definitely recommend it. I'll post a link in the description, but you can get it from onecarstereo.com. It's normally $499, but they have it on sale right now for $359. And then if you use promo code TECHJEFF, you can save 10%, which brings it to $323 with free shipping. And honestly, that's a pretty good deal when you consider all the functionality it includes. Dash cam, wireless CarPlay and wireless Android Auto, the ability to watch movies on your car's display, thousands of apps in the Google Play Store. It's got a lot of features, so... Anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comments, and if you have any questions, let me know. Be sure to subscribe for more product reviews, automotive and tech videos, giveaways, and thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.